Hi everyone, welcome back. Over the next few minutes, I'll be showing you how to apply tools and indicators to your charts and how to change them to your preferred settings. So let's just open up a regular bar chart. I'm going to click on New, Single Code Chart, Bar Chart to bring up the security selection window. And I'm going to open up Apple, so AAPL, and hit Enter. And that's opened up on the screen there with my default bar colors and time frame. So to apply tools, we've got a tools menu in the top of the screen there. And if we click the all option on the left, this will give us an alphabetical list of all the tools that you have access to on your copy. Now it will depend on the tool modules that you have access to. But we've got well over 200 types of technical tools and indicators, and you can also create your own using the scripting language as well, but we'll leave that for another video. So going back to the screen, as you can see, they're all listed alphabetically, and we also have them grouped by folders, so types of tools. So averages, these are all the average tools, cycles, Fibonacci, so on and so forth. So you can go through them and see what we have. Or if we click on the all again, so they're all listed, we can click in the search box there and type for what we're looking for. So I'm going to look for moving averages. So start typing, and then you can see everything that has MOV in its name is listed in the below there. And as we mouse over, there's a little thumbnail on the right-hand side giving you a preview of the tool and also a brief description. And also more information, if you click that link underneath the thumbnail there, that will open up the online knowledge base article on our website. So I'm gonna just put on a standard moving average, so I'm gonna select that. As you can see, my cursor has now changed into a pencil, so when I click, the moving average with the default settings has been added to the chart. If we go over to the properties panel on the left-hand side, because this tool is the last thing that we applied to the chart, the properties are now reflecting that tool. So tool name there is moving average. This is a 5 period. So if you want to change that, let's click on that and change it to 20, or we can use the arrows there, and you can see as we do that, the tool automatically gets recalculated on the screen, or we can click and drag inside that box and move your mouse up and down, and you can see the moving average dynamically change there. But let's put that back to 20. Calculation style, simple is the default setting, but let's say we want to change that to exponential based on the close instead of the high-low close. We can change the offset, so we can shift the moving average backwards and forwards in time. We can change the line style from solid to dashes or dots, and also the width. So again, roll your mouse wheel to increase that value or type the value in, and also change the color, obviously. So let's change that to red. So pretty much every tool that we have, once it's enabled or clicked on in the properties, you can change the settings. So let's do another example, this time of what we call a drawing tool or a static tool, one that is you place on the chart, such as a trend line. So we could go through the tools menu again and search for trend, but what I'm going to show you now is the right-click menu. So instead of going through the menu at the top, we can right-click on the chart background, go to the wrench icon, and in the search box there, we can start typing trend, and then all the tools, much like we did in the search box in the actual tools menu, all the tools with trend in its name are displayed there. So I want trend line there. And again, you'll see my cursor's changed to a pencil. And because I've got the price lock feature on, which is the padlock icon on the left-hand side of the screen, I've got a little cross that follows my cursor. And that means it's going to snap to the closest high-low close point to my cursor. So as this is a trend line, I'm going to left-click once and drag that up to put on the chart. And again, just like the moving average, the properties on the left-hand side have changed. So very similar, we can change the line width, we can change the color, we can extend left and right, we can even show the angle. So that will be displayed on the chart as well, and also the transparency. A lot of these tools have the same types of property in terms of transparency and colors and line types and things like that, but it's the other properties that are specific to that particular tool that can also be changed. So I'm going to do one more type of tool, which is, let's do a MACD. So again, I'm going to use the right-click menu. Now you see that list there, that's the last few tools that I've used, and it remembers them, so you don't even have to type them again. It will just remember the last 10, I think, tools that you used. So you can see I've used MACD combo. So I'm just going to select that, and that's going to automatically be applied below the chart. Now, once again, the properties have changed. But what I'm going to show you this time, I'm going to roll this panel away. So the actions and the properties are now hidden from view. But we can still change the properties, again, by using the right-click menu. So I'm going to right-click on that MACD, on any one of those lines or histograms, and the properties can be found under the pencil. So by default, this one has been set to 525.5. I'm going to change this to 12, 26, and 9. And I'm also going to change the histogram color from blue to black. I'm going to change it not from a single color. I'm going to change it positive to negative. So obviously green is a positive histogram and red is negative. Now, I don't want to make these changes every time I apply this MACD tool. So now I'm going to go over to the actions, which is the running man. And you can see the bottom option there, save settings as default. And when I click that, I get that little message there, successfully save settings. So now, every time we apply the MACD, it will have those colors. So I'll just show you an example there. I'm going to right click, and this time go to the trash can to delete. And that's remove the MACD, and I'm going to reapply it. So I'm going to go back to the right click, wrench, click on MACD, and you can see now that it's set to 12.26.9 with the colors that I have saved as default. Okay, one more example I want to finish up with. I'm going to remove the MACD again. So I'm just going to right-click on that, either go to the delete icon or I can hit the delete key on my keyboard as well. For this example, I'm going to put on volume. So again, right-click, wrench, start typing volume, and all those volume tools will be displayed. And there's the one I want in the middle there. And that's going to put each day's volume in a chart as per normal. But this time I'm going to put a moving average on the volume, not the actual price chart. And the way we can do that, either through the tools menu or the right click menu, is if we right click in the volume panel of the window, and then there's my moving average. I'm going to select that, and it's going to automatically put it on the volume as opposed to the price chart, because that's where my cursor was when I chose that tool. And again, with a moving average, we changed it in the properties panel on the left-hand side, but likewise, we can do exactly the same thing using the right-click menu. So I'm going to change this to a 20-period moving average based on the close. I'm going to change it to a red line, and I'm going to show in price scale. So for this particular chart, so for Apple, that's been averaging 20 million shares a day over the last 20 days. So we can actually right-click in that volume price scale and change the decimals. So instead of having it just set to zero decimals, it's actually 20.41 million. So So that was a brief overview of how to apply tools and indicators to your charts and change the settings. Any questions, as always, please let us know. Thanks very much.